Now, let us solve a problem. Observe the following tables and find which pair of variables are in inverse proportion. Now, in the first table, the values of x and y are given. Now, how to check whether the two quantities are said to be in inverse proportion? So, let us find the product of the two quantities in each case. If the product remains a constant, then the two quantities are said to be in inverse proportion. Now, let us find the product of these two quantities in each case. Now, in the first case, so when you multiply 50 into 5, then we get 250. And if you multiply x value and y value in the second case, we get 40 into 6 equals to 240. So, these two are not equal. Then we need not check for further cases. Then we can write that 50 into 5 is not equal to 40 into 6. So, we can write that x1 into y1 is not equal to x2 into y2. So, then the two quantities x and y are not in inverse proportion. So, then let us check the second problem. Here x values are given and y values are also given. Then here also we will find the product of these two quantities in each case. So, in the first case, x1 y1 equals to 100 into 60 equals to 6000. Now, in the second case, x2 y2 equals to 200 into 30. This equals to 3 2s are 6, then 3 zeros. So, this is also 6000. And let us check in the third case, x3 y3. This equals to 300 into 20. So, this equals to 3 2s are 6, then 3 zeros. So, this is also 6000. And let us check the last case, x4, y4, x4 into y4. This equals to 400 into 15. This equals to 15, 4s are 60, then these two zeros. So, this is also 6000. So, we get here x1 into y1 equals to x2 into y2 equals to x3 into y3 equals to x4 into y4. Means we get x into y equals to a constant k, means that constant value is here 6000. So, the product of these two quantities x into y equal to 6000. So, the product of these two quantities remains a constant. So, these two quantities are in inverse proportion. Now, let us solve a problem. If a box of sweets divided among 24 children, then they will get 5 sweets each. How many would each get if the number of the children is reduced by 4. Now, there is a box of sweets. So, in the box some sweets are there. Now, here the two quantities are there. The number of children and the number of sweets each child gets. So, if the number of children is 24, the number of children and the number of sweets each child gets. So, these are the two quantities in this problem. But here there are the fixed number of sweets in the box. If 24 children are there, then each child gets 5 sweets. Means we can understand that 24 into 5, 120. So, there are only 120 sweets in the box. So, the number of sweets is fixed here. And if the number of children is reduced by 4, so minus 4 means 20, then how many sweets each child gets? So, this we have to find. When the number of children is 24, then each child gets 5 sweets. So, when the number of children is 20, then how many sweets each child gets? You have to find this value. Now, whether they are in direct proportion or inverse proportion. So, obviously they are said to be in inverse proportion, because if there are 24 children, then they will get 5 sweets each. If there are only 20 children, then obviously they get more sweets from 120 sweets. So here, this is a case of inverse proportion. In inverse proportion, we know that the product of two quantities remains a constant. So in this 24 into 5 equals to 20 into y, or we can write that 20 into y equals to 24 into 5. So when you transpose into 20 to RHS, it becomes pi 20. So then we get y equals to 24 into 5 by 20. Now you can cancel. 4 6 are 24, 4 5 are 20, and 5 1 are 5, 5 1 are 5. So then y value is 6. Therefore, each child gets 6 sweets. So when the number of children is 20, then each child is getting 6 sweets. Now let us see the next question. A farmer has enough food to feed 20 animals in his cattle for 6 days. How long would the food last if there were 10 more animals in his cattle? Now he has enough food to feed 20 animals in his cattle for 6 days. So he has some food which can feed 20 animals for 6 days. So here the two quantities are there. The first quantity is the number of animals, and the second quantity is number of days. If there are 20 animals in his cattle, so he can feed the food for 6 days. And if there were 10 more animals, so 20 plus 10, then this equals to 30. So if there are 30 animals in his cattle, then how long he can feed the food for 30 animals? So you should find out the number of days. So let the number of days be y. Now if he has 20 animals in his cattle, then he can feed the food for 6 days. So if he has more animals, means 30, 10 more animals means 30 animals in his cattle, then the food lasts only few days, so less than 6 days. So yeah, this quantity is increasing, whereas this quantity is decreasing. So this is said to be in the case of inverse proportion. So this is a case of inverse proportion. So as we know that when two quantities are in inverse proportion, the product of first quantity and the second quantity remains a constant. So here we can write that 20 into 6 equals to 30 into y, or 30 into y equals to 20 into 6. Then y equals to 20 into 6 by 30. Here you can cancel 0 and 0, then 3 1s are 3, 3 2s are 6. So y equals to 2 2s are 4. So the number of days is 4, means for 4 days he can feed the food for 30 animals. So he can when the number of cattle is 30. Now let us see the next question. A car takes 2 hours to reach a destination by traveling at the speed of 60 km/h. How long will it take when the car travels at the speed of 80 km/h? So here also two quantities are given, that the first quantity is the speed of the car and the second quantity is time taken to travel the destination. Now the speed of the car is the first quantity. And time taken to reach the destination, that is the second quantity. Now we will write the values of the first quantity and the second quantity in the table. So when the speed of, now a car takes 2 hours to reach a destination, so it is, when it is taking 2 hours, then what is the speed of the car? 60 km/h. Then when the speed of the car is 80 km/h, then how long will it take? Then we should find out the time taken by the car at the speed 80 km/h. So we should find out y value. So as we know that when the speed 60 km/h, then the car is taking 2 hours to reach the destination. So when the speed of the car increases, then definitely it will take less time to reach the destination. So here if one quantity increases, then automatically the other quantity is decreasing. So then we can say that these two quantities, means the speed of the car and time taken to reach the destination, so these two quantities are in inverse proportion. So let the time taken by B Y hours. Now this is a case of inverse proportion. So this is a case of inverse proportion. So we know that in inverse proportion, the product of two quantities remains a constant. So in this case, the product of these two quantities in first case, 60 into 2 equals to the product of the two quantities in the second case, that is 80 into y. So then we can write that 80 into y equals to 60 into 2. Then this implies y equals to 60 into 2 by 80. So we can cancel here 0 and 0. Then 2 3s are 6, 2 4s are 8, and 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4. So y equals to 3 by 2, this equals to 1.5 hours. So therefore, the car will take 1.5 hours to reach the destination at the speed of 80 km/h. So let us solve the next question. A school has 8 periods a day, each of 45 minutes duration. So how long would each period be? If the school has 9 periods a day, assuming the number of school hours to be the same. Now here two quantities are there. The first quantity is the number of periods per day and the second quantity is duration of each period. So you will write those two quantities in your table so that we can understand. So the first quantity is the number of periods per day and the second quantity is duration of each period. Now let us write the values of each quantity. Now there, if the school has 8 periods a day, so if there are 8 periods, so the number of periods is 8, then 45 minutes duration of each period, so we can write here 45 minutes. If the school has to be the same, if you assume that the school maintains the same hours every day, then if the school has 9 periods, if the number of periods per day is 9, then what is the duration of each period? So you should find out this value. So it is y. So let the duration of each period be y minutes. So when the school has considered the same, then if the number of periods is 8, then duration of each period is 45 minutes. So when you take more one period, means if the number of periods is increased by 1, then definitely the duration of each period decreases. So if the first quantity increases, then the second quantity decreases, so that the product of those two quantities remains the constant. So then we can say that these two quantities are said to be in inverse proportion. So this is a case of inverse proportion. So we know that in inverse proportion, the product of two quantities is the same. So we can write that 8 into 45 equals to 9 into y. Then we can write this as 9 into y equals to 8 into 45. So then y equals to 8 into 45 by 9. So 9 ones are 9, 9 fives are 45. Then y equals to 8 fives are 40. So there are 40 minutes of each period, means duration of each period is 40 minutes. So when you take the number of periods as 9, so the duration of each period equals to 40 minutes.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.